It's often convenient for us to view an angle as a dynamic object. That is, rather than thinking of it as just a union of two rays that just kind of sits there like a lump on the plane, we can think of it as an amount of rotation, a turn, if you will. If you think about actually turning a crank, where you start your turn and where you end your turn does not tell you the whole story. You need to know which direction you turned and maybe how many times around you turned the crank before stopping. So when we look at angles in terms of rotation, we're going to need to distinguish between the starting point and the ending point and the direction of turn. So for instance, here's three examples. I have one in the upper left here where the initial side and the terminal side are labeled thus. Notice the animation in the background. There's a bit, just a hint of rotation that is going from this side to that side. Right? In contrast, this example here uses the same two line segments. The amount of turn in between them is the same. However, this now is the initial side, and the terminal side's down here. Notice the background is animated so that it turns from the top down to the bottom here. So where this is a counterclockwise rotation, this is a clockwise rotation. Right? Third example down here looks a lot like the first one, where the initial side is down on the bottom and the terminal side is this diagonal here. But this has clockwise rotation going around the big angle on the outside. Right? This is animated to turn this way. Okay. Three different angles, all using the same two sides. There are other angles that could be represented by these two sides as well, because we could start, let's say, at the initial side, rotate in a counterclockwise direction, and go around once or twice before actually finishing on that terminal side. Okay. There are times throughout this course where the geometric interpretation will be sufficient for what we're doing. We don't really need to distinguish between this angle or that angle. We don't care about which direction we're turning. There are other times, though, where we definitely do need to be able to distinguish. So we need both concepts, the geometric angle and the rotational angle. Next, we want to take a look at a silly story that I call the Goo Factory.